What is good, everybody? My name is Tatro. I am a lo-fi beat maker and a music producer based in LA. And today I'm here to check out the new lo-fi line in Arcade called Downtime. I recently created a full lo-fi beat using exclusively the sounds from Downtime. And in this video, I'm gonna show you all the different ways I used the Downtime line in that beat. If at any point during this video you're inspired to go make your own lo-fi beat with Downtime, remember that you can currently try it with a free trial of Arcade. That link is down in the description as well. Without further ado, let's get into the beat. So within the Downtime line, you have access to three categories of sounds: sampler kits, note kits, and samples. And I want to start by showing you a sampler kit I used called Rekindled Memory. Oftentimes, sampler kits contain the major elements of a track, like a main sample and drums. And just by holding down the keys, you have access to these interactive loops that you can start making a song with. And that's how I opened my track. I opened with the sound of this main sample and snare backbeat. And as you can probably already hear, the sounds in Downtime are curated exclusively for making lo-fi or chill hop music, so they've got that quality to them. Sampler kits also include things like textures and drums, but this one, just by holding down the keys, you have access to some pretty inspiring loops. Now that's how I started my track, but by the midpoint I wanted to switch things up, so I loaded up this other sampler kit, Twilight Glow. So I could take my track in a new direction at that midpoint. So not only within these sampler kits do you have access to very cool loops, but you also have access to a type of performance effects called modifiers. So you'll notice that I was holding down white keys to play my main loops, but then I can also use the black keys to create cool real-time effects. All these different modifiers can resequence, filter, or even reverse your samples in real time. And you can see those displayed here right on the black keys on the keyboard layout. And you can even go in and edit these. There are sort of these presets for the modifiers as well, where you can resequence, change the playhead direction, or turn it into a repeater so you can create a stutter effect. I did this at the midpoint of my song as well. And what's really cool about this is you can also see them in the MIDI piano roll. So every time you see that D sharp there, that's me triggering one of those modifiers. So it actually is really easy not only to play them in real time, but you can also draw in certain places where you want to trigger a modifier. Next, let's talk about drums. So I know I showed you in the sampler kits that you could really easily load up those drum loops that are already built in, but what I did instead within Arcade was create my own custom kit where you can import samples from your library. And of course, within the Downtime line, we have samples created specifically for lo-fi, so it's really easy to find, but many of them are loops. So let me show you how I created that one-shot style drum kit with samples from Downtime. Within the line, we can search for samples, and we can also search by type of instrument. If we scroll down and find a drum instrument, like say snare, we can look at all of the samples tagged snare in the line. And I can grab any of these and drag them to an empty key within my kit here. Now these are samples that I've already downloaded, but if you see a little cloud icon here, just make sure you click that and download it. But now if I go into that sample that I just grabbed here, I can see that it's clearly meant to be a loop. And if I hold down the key, it's gonna play through that loop. But we don't want that. We wanna just trigger this as if it were a one-shot sample. So snap is already turned off for us here. We can also turn looping off. And now we can just change these start and end points. Try to get that start point right to the beginning. Perfect, right there. So this is how I built this whole kit, so that I could finger drum live for the beat session. Sometimes you want to use drum loops, other times you want to play in your own rhythms. And this functionality with custom kits gives you that freedom. And that was really easy. So in a section like bar 9 of my beat, you're hearing a kit that I played live, snare and percussion and kick. That was all played in live. But then I combine it with some of the loops from downtime, like this hi-hat or this shaker. Combine them all together. We've taken one-shot samples and loops in downtime, combined them to make our own rhythm. One thing you may notice in my project here is that actually my kick and my snare and percussion are on separate tracks. I do this so that I can create a sidechain source from the kick. So I go through my session and I play drums as normal, which gives me one combined MIDI file with kick, snare, and whatever drum samples I triggered. But then I duplicate those and separate the kick out. This way, I can set up a sidechain compressor, which is actually something that creates a pumping sound reacting to the kick on my other instruments. So if you see on my main loop here, I've got this compressor in sidechain mode, and I've got it soloed, but if you can hear that triggering, that ducking, it's actually responding to the kick. I've got that sidechain on all of the instruments in my project, and that pumping sensation for me is a key part of my lo-fi beats because it lets that kick punch through and it almost gives the sound of like a retro speaker where the bass is just overpowering. Okay, so finally, not only do we want to be able to play in our own rhythms, we also want to be able to play in our own musical ideas, which we can totally do with note kits within downtime. So note kits are fully playable instruments, and just like all the other sounds in downtime, they're specifically made for lo-fi. So lots of electric piano and sort of retro synths. And as you can hear from this note kit, which is called A Little Dream, they sound pretty good. And each of these sounds actually has 4 macros. So we can pretty quickly start creating changes with our sound, adding a bit of delay. I've added quite a bit of reverb wash to this sound because that's just the sound that I like. We could also dial in this phaser. But aside from these 4 macros, we can go deeper and we can hit the tweak button. And this gives us access to each of the individual layers that goes into making this sound. So you can see that this sound has 2 layers, a gong. Let's turn that off. We can hear without. And all we're left with is the tail of that auto harp. But together, they make a pretty beautiful keyboard sound. There's also things in here like an arpeggiator. Which of course you can change all the settings for, but I also want to show you the mixer, which is pretty deep. You know, you have the mixer for your whole project with effects and things like that, but each of the layers of this individual instrument, we have the ability to add different effects built right in here into Arcade. And then you can also send it to different effects as well as have master effects on this individual instrument. So you can really go deep with editing some of these sounds and making them to your liking. That's just one of the note kits I used in the project, but at the end, I used this lead called Cozy Retro, which has this really nice glide. The wash once again, but you can see that this sound has its own set of macros, including flutter, which that motion is super key to making lo-fi beats. And this sound actually has 3 different layers to it, all with their own adjustments, their own filters, and their own amp envelopes, things like that. Perfect for adding your own melodies and chords to your tracks. And one final note on these macros, you can also automate these in your DAW like you would any other effect. So this downsample macro on my main loop could be a lot of fun to play with for a transition. So I've gone ahead and clicked on my downsample knob here. And drawn in an automation so that right at that transition point, we get a cool downsample effect. It sounds like this. And it leads perfectly into the next section. So there you go. We've gone from starting out our track with loops in the sampler kits, creating fun momentary effects with the modifiers, building our own drum kits, and then diving in with the note kits to add our own chords and melodies. And once again, every sound you heard in this beat came from the downtime line. And if you want to try that out, there is a free trial link down in the description. Hopefully we've inspired you to make your own lo-fi beats. And if we have, let us know down in the comment. Also, let us know if you have any questions about Arcade or the downtime line specifically. Once again, my name is Tatro. You can check me out at youtube.com/Tatro for more educational content, lo-fi beats, and live streams. But of course, make sure you're subscribed to the Output channel for more content here. Thank you all so much for watching. This has been Tatro for Output. Have a good one.